This is Whispering Whim. Today's video is going to be a couple of different shopping trips, so they'll be taken on different days, and hopefully I can get the volume all evened out so it's not too jarring day to day. I did that right after Halloween, and a couple of people were pretty excited about having a bonus video, so I'm gonna try for another bonus video. But anyways, today's shopping, we have a party to go up to, so I got some beer and some, what would you call it, alcoholic sodas, because I love the Not Your Father's Root Beer, as you may know, if you watch the Halloween haul video. And, the party is overnight, so I got some danishes. So we have an easy breakfast in the morning. They actually cook breakfast, and I prefer to get the hot, not sweet thing, but I'm kind of the lone wolf in that. It's me and all the old people have real breakfast, and then all the young people have danishes at like lunchtime. So, what can you do, right? And then I did a trip to the dollar store and just got some basic stuff that, you know, is cheaper at the dollar store or same price. So, some sponges. And I got a little duster, microfiber. We usually all dust with like paper towels, but I have a feeling this will work better, so we'll see. Some little paring knives. I don't have high hopes for the sharpness of these. However, I don't know if you know or not, but I am a baker, or more accurately put, I am a decorator. So, you know, making cakes and chocolate sculptures and things like that. And long story short, these are actually really helpful tools when you do chocolate stuff. Like, you can use them to make chocolate leaves, for example, or petals. So there's a couple of different uses, so they don't have to be super sharp for that. Just more of like a really thin spatula at that point. And then I got some Tupperware containers. I already have this size, and it's the size I use the most of, so I figured having a couple more would be smart. If you listen to me babble enough, you'll know that I try to reduce my waste, and so, you know, I'll buy things in bigger bags and move them down into, you know, Tupperware and stuff like that. So I really try. It's not, I like convenience too. I like individually packaged things. It's just easy. So I'm always at war with myself, it seems. Next up, we got some little clips. I've been needing to have some extra bag clips, right? You know, for potato chips or whatever, because I only have one. So if we open two different kinds, then we're out of luck, right? And I had to get the chickens, or the rubber duckies. There were other packs at the dollar store, and I could have gotten like 8 of them for the same price, but they weren't cute. And that's important. So I got the ducks. Just a little bit of chocolate. Last time I was at Winco, I got some chocolate out of the bins, right? And I made the mistake of letting everyone know that I got chocolate, and now it's all gone. It got eaten really fast. Next up is just some hand soap. need some for the bathroom. And I did debate whether or not to get a bar soap or one of these, because bar soaps tend to be better for the environment. But I really like the convenience, so there's an example of when I'm a bad girl. And then I'm guilty of buying some more socks that I definitely don't need. There's actually on my channel a sock sorting video because I have like, I don't know, maybe 50, 60 different pairs of socks. I'm a little obsessed with them, so I got more because, you know, like you do. And then just some regular hair ties. I am down to my last hair tie from a pack that I bought like a year ago. And the one could potentially last forever, right? You know, could just need that one for like the next 3 years. But if I don't buy a backup one, or in this case, a whole backup pack, right? Then I'm gonna lose it or break it, and that's bad. As I said, I work in a bakery, so you have to put your hair up. And I am not using rubber bands. And then this bag is just some tin foil containers. I'm gonna bake the macaroni and cheese in these because every time there's a big gathering, I have to make macaroni and cheese. And it's just much more cost effective to buy these at the dollar store. Because I think Winco wanted to charge like $3 for a single one of these, and Walmart wanted to charge like $1.10. Whereas, you know, for $2, I got four of them. So. Yay, dollar store. I was at Walmart though. That's where I got my liquor from. That's definitely not a dollar store find. And I usually shop at a different store. So whenever I'm at Walmart and I have to go there for some reason, I tend to go a little overboard. Buying all the things I can't normally find at the other store. So I bought three bags of edamame, plus, so those are like the bigger portions, right? On top of that, I bought a box of little bags. So, I will have edamame for a while, hopefully. But these bigger bags, sometimes that's what I eat for lunch. It's not terrible, you know, and it's a snack type thing. So, my brain goes, okay, this is a good lunch. Because I love to just kind of absent-mindedly eat, I guess. So, I try to do sunflower seeds and edamame and things that have protein in them, you know, not just potato chips or candy bars, which are also very tasty. So, just take out all of the edamame here. And since this is a smaller video, I'll put everything away after the camera's off. At least we can do this all in relatively one take. And then the other thing I got is some riced cauliflower. For some reason, this is very hard to find at Winco. I find it sometimes, and then other days there's not a single variety. Whereas Walmart has like four or five different varieties. So I got this one, which is a risotto melody. So it has little bits of mushroom. And then I got the cauliflower melody, which is kind of more like stir fry kind of a flavor. I really enjoy supplementing my meals with those. I don't know why Winco doesn't have them. And then, if you watch enough of these, you know that I'm not a fan of Winco's tea selection. And I finally, after like 2 months, right, I bought some more tea at a different store. And because, the weather is colder and we haven't had it in a while, we drank like a box and a half of tea. So I picked up some more while I was at Walmart, because even though they don't have very fancy brands, they have like decent brands. I don't know why Winco. They're a lot cheaper on most things, and they definitely have a great produce section, but they just don't always have what I want. So this is a little guilty pleasure. I picked up some prosciutto, and just a few little individual ones, because it's a very rich food, and I don't need a lot of it, but every once in a while I crave it. So I saw them, I bought them. They were overpriced. Should have bought something else, but it's okay. You gotta live a little, right? And then, last but not least, I picked up some headache relief, the generic Excedrin. Just a simple thing that I needed. So this I spent enough time blabbing that I almost could count this as a video by itself. We'll see. I think there's some more small trips to come up that we're just gonna bundle all together, right? Okay, so I just got back from Walmart. It was supposed to be a really small shopping trip because I needed some TP. But anyways, I've already done my introductions a few weeks ago when I recorded the first part. So we're gonna jump right in. I got a little container for candies. I make truffles and things like that, and it is a highly requested gift, so I'm gonna cheat and just make a bunch of candies. Some mini donuts. It's a pretty common item for me, right? And a bit of tuna fish. Just kind of a just in case pack here. I hate being wasteful, but sometimes it's good when you need lunch for work, right? Then got me some spring rolls. This was kind of an impulse buy, which made my total grander than I intended. I had a gift card that I was only going to spend the amount on the gift card, and I failed royally. Well, not royally. I failed by about $23. Next up, got a box of crackers, individually wrapped. They're really great for the lunches, and I only see them at Walmart. I don't see them at Winco, which is my usual spot for grocery shopping. So when I'm at Walmart, I tend to just pick one up. Then another sort of only at Walmart kind of a thing. They have a few different food items. I've got some mushroom pasta, penne, and a mushroom sauce. So I'm curious to see how that tastes. got some protein bars and some fruit bars. Again, those are for the lunches. I spoil my guy. And I don't usually remember to pack myself a lunch because he works in an office, so I just put it in a big old lunch pail and I send him off. Well, I work in a bakery, so I can't just pack up a giant lunch pail, you know. I can bring things, but I don't trust them in the community area. So if I can't fit it in my car or you know, something like that, I don't bring it. Anyways, another random pasta that I found at Walmart, and this has 26 grams of protein, so it's protein pasta. And I do try to eat like pseudo vegetarian, like one night a week, just 'cause I've seen a lot of documentaries, and I can't make that commitment to full vegetarian, but it's good for the environment if you cut out animal proteins once in a while. So I do that. Eat my lentils and my beans. My guy is not a fan of it, but meh. I'm the cook. I get to decide. Next up is two cans of condensed milk. And this is for a surprise that I have coming up. I ordered a bunch of stuff off of Amazon using my other gift cards. So we're gonna try making some Thai iced tea. And I will do a video for my Amazon purchases here coming up because there were quite a few of them. Tis the season, right? So look forward to that. An extra update this month. Yay! Hopefully. It's been a really busy month so far. Then some cream cheese for cream cheese jalapenos and also for bagels. I've been on a really big bagel kick, and I'm always disappointed when I'm at not Walmart or not Winco. Sorry, I'm really like hyper today, so I gotta keep my voice nice and calm. Winco has fabulous bagels, so slather those with cream cheese and I'm a happy girl. And I got some at Save Mart, I don't know, like a week or two ago, and they weren't as great. And today, Walmart doesn't have the individuals, they just have like Sara Lee and, you know, name brand stuff. So, somewhere in here, we have some Sara Lee bagels. Sourdough bread for steak sandwiches. Love me some steak sandwich. I can't decide whether it's the steak part or the caramelized onion, but I always do it on sourdough, so it's got a lot of kick and oomph, and I don't know. I just love it. And then, as mentioned, are Sara Lee bagels. They feel squishy. Hopefully they're as tasty as those ones that I got from Winco, because man, I have been craving them for like weeks now. I want my Winco bagels. But it's not worth dealing with Winco traffic unless I'm, you know, shopping for a couple of things. And then, moving right along. Sorry, I don't know why I'm so hyper today. I got some shampoo and conditioner. It was cheaper to buy this like gift pack of shampoo and conditioner, so we'll give that a go. And speaking of, I'm thinking of cutting my hair. What do you guys think? Maybe to right about there? It's been kind of, you know, lackluster lately. And curling it can be a bit of a pain, so I don't know. I'm thinking about chopping it off. If you have an opinion about that, you let me know. In the meantime, here is some body wash, just some basic $2 a bottle stuff for, you know, washing my body. All right, so I'm actually done already. For some reason, I thought I had another bag, and I was just, I raced through all of that really quickly. I almost thought about putting it all back in the bags and like starting fresh, but that's okay. I think combined with the other shopping trips that are gonna be, you know, earlier, it's a good video, right? Maybe. Let me know what you think about this whole combination trip thing. Like I said in one of my other videos, or maybe earlier, I don't remember. I only do the big grocery hauls once a month, but this might be a way for me to squeeze in an extra shopping video once in a while if I save up some of my smaller trips. So if you have an opinion on that, I'd love to hear it. Otherwise, I just want to say thank you for joining me, and especially my subscribers for continuing to watch me. It does make me feel good. Beyond that, I hope you have a wonderful evening, and happy holidays.